hundreds of thousands of chefs all across America dream of standing in front of these two doors.
Are you ready?
Yes, chef.
Yes, chef.
Each season on Hell's Kitchen, one door is unlocked. And a dream... Yeah! ...is fulfilled.
Yeah! Oh, my God!
Ladies and gentlemen, Hell's Kitchen winner, Nona!
Now, opportunity is knocking on doors all across America.
Congratulations, you have been chosen to be a
chef on Hell's Kitchen!
I'm gonna win!
I will dominate!
Victory Jersey fish, my baby, yeah!
This year, 18 chefs from across America descend on Hell's Kitchen, hoping they have the qualities they need to succeed.
I hate fucking losing.
Like Team Spirit.
You better get out of my face!
He can't cook scallops! He can't get the fucking risotto out!
Intelligence.
Why can't we just fucking reheat them?
Falling apart.
What are we gonna learn?
Fuck off.
Diplomacy.
Shut up for 5 seconds.
I will fucking slap you across the goddamn kitchen. Stupid.
Humility.
Sorry, I'm sorry, chef. I'm sorry, chef. I'm sorry, chef. It's my fault, chef. I'm very sorry, chef.
Passion.
This is what I've worked for my whole life.
I'm not just some fucking pantry girl.
Hold on. Cry time?
Drive.
Tommy, talk to me!
I work fucking hard with them, for them.
Ouch! I'm not giving up,
well,
chef.
Well, fucking fight back!
I got it, chef, I got it.
And an inquisitive nature.
Let me ask you a serious question right now. Do you take medication?
Never before has a group of chefs been so hungry for victory.
Never fucking quit. I signed up to win!
Never before has Chef Ramsay been so demanding.
It's full! It's burnt!
Raw!
Sufficient!
This is embarrassing!
It's the most volatile season yet.
Hang your heads in shame.
Wow!
These chefs will find out when they enter these doors.
It is a living hell.
That they're about to be pushed harder than any chefs before.
Oh, no! No! It's disgusting!
Chef, I...
Shut up!
Let's go, you!
3 minutes, I said!
Shut up! You want me to get out? Then I'll get out!
Get out!
Get out!
Oh, my God!
What are you gonna do now? Any suggestions?
Shut it down!
Shut it down!
I'm starting to understand why they call it Hell's Kitchen.
Welcome, everybody. I'm James. I'm the maitre d' here at Hell's Kitchen. So, are you excited to go to Hell's Kitchen?
Yeah! I can't wait to start cooking.
I'm a rock star in my own world, so being here and being treated like rock star isn't really that much of a difference.
Where are we?
Ramsay's house.
I have the biggest crush on him.
I am the hottest chef in the hottest restaurant in Dallas. Me and Chef Ramsay would be like that.
Watch out.
Oh, I walk tall, take them all, big or small, and never fall. I'm here to win it, baby.
Everybody likes to have a good time, but it's not, let's try to be nice and hold hands and be friends. It's me versus you, and I'm gonna steamroll you.
While the chefs are anxious to have their first taste of Hell's Kitchen,
Hell's Kitchen, what?
Chef Ramsay has decided to give them an unexpected detour.
We pulled up outside, and it was like, welcome, Hell's Kitchen chefs. What? Like, what is going on?
Guys, so it looks like we've arrived.
Yeah. Let's go, off the bus, please. Let's go.
I was super excited and nervous, like, what's going on? Like, holy shit.
Go chefs are coming through, watch, please.
Watch out, hot pan. One, two, three, go to hair and makeup. Let's go.
You gonna make me look good, girl?
All of a sudden, we're getting hair and makeup. It was insane. I mean, this is how a superstar feels. Oh, my God, I love it.
You guys ready to head upstairs?
Yeah. Good luck. Hey.
We're gonna need it. Good luck, everybody. We can hear like a crowd in the background. Everyone's getting so excited.
Yeah! 2 minutes. We ready?
What the hell is going on here? Like, we are not really gonna cook our signature dishes for all these people.
30 seconds.
A lot of people out there just like see us. Damn, this is like the real deal.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Orpheum Theater. Please put your hands together for the Hell's Kitchen chefs.
Seriously, what on earth did you expect? A packed house? A standing ovation? Screaming fans? Really?
Right now, none of you are stars. Resumes mean nothing. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Got it?
Yes, sir.
Unfucking real.
I felt like I was getting berated. I wanted to just be like, oh, we're unworthy, we're unworthy. But then I was like, boom, back down to earth.
I'm looking for someone to emerge and prove to me that they're worthy of being called a star. Because this season of Hell's Kitchen, the winner will earn a salary of $250,000.
Yes!
The winner will become the head chef in the most competitive restaurant city anywhere in the world. New York City.
You know, I know I'm from down south, but absolutely ready to handle the big time, man.
Yeah. $250,000 and in New York, it blew my mind. It blew my mind.
The winner will become the head chef at the upscale, unique, prestigious BLT Steak.
BLT Steak is absolutely amazing. I'm from New York City. I couldn't have wished for a more perfect scenario.
Get your asses back to Hell's Kitchen and cook me the best dish you've ever cooked. Got it?
Yes, chef. Yes, sir.
Get out of here. Off you go. Let's go. Don't stand there waiting for me. Let's go. Oh, stars, my ass.
Of being head chef still lingering in their minds, the chefs will now have 45 minutes to prepare their signature dishes.
Slow down.
Yeah, that's me right there.
Okay, just say that. Then it's cool.
Calm down.
My name is Elise. I am from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. I am definitely not afraid to fight back.
Scared? Are you scared?
They better watch themselves.
It's good. It's good. Why are you still talking?
Oh, we playing like that?
You got 250K on the line. Like, I will elbow my mom by my way.
20 minutes to go.
Actually, being in Hell's Kitchen and cooking your signature dish, it's a little surreal at first.
Hop on, behind.
But when it comes down to it, it's the same shit, different toilet. You know what I'm saying? Same bologna, different bread.
If you want a bowl, the bowls are up in the back.
Thank you. All right.
10 minutes to go.
Boil over here.
My competitors will absolutely be intimidated by me. As soon as I walk into a room, every eye is on me. It's just something, some aura that I give off.
Down the line.
3 minutes to go.
Excuse me.
I don't know whose plate this is, but it's gonna get knocked over. You better not knock my plate over.
I got a little nervous and I got a little frazzled, and it felt like those 45 minutes went by like that.
15 seconds to go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and serve, yes?
Yes, sir.
The signature dishes are a chance for you to shine and stand out as individuals. But this is actually your first team challenge. The men's dishes will go head-to-head with the ladies' dishes.
Let's get them, boys.
Excellent. Let's go.
First up in the signature dish challenge,
let's go.
Carrie, the pantry chef from Dallas, Texas, will face off against Will, a sous chef from New Jersey.
Ladies first, what is it?
It is a chicken fried ribeye with Yukon Gold Mash and white truffle cream gravy. I actually have a little sugar in there.
Stop, say that again.
I have sugar in there. That's what my mother always did.
I do not know who in their right mind would put sugar in mashed potatoes.
Just try it. Chef Ramsay is gonna love it because it's freaking delicious. It's like an orgasm in your mouth. Come on. Oh.
I'm sorry, I don't mean to laugh.
That. It's disgusting. Okay, first name?
Will from North Jersey.
Heritage, Italian?
Italian and Jewish. I grew up, my friends call me a pizza bagel.
Okay, what is it?
It is sheep's milk nudie. I'm a technician when it comes to culinary, you know what I'm saying? I don't worry about somebody eating my food. I do it and I do it right.
That is delicious.
Thanks, chef.
Great job.
Thanks, chef.
A point to the pizza bagel. Congratulations.
Yeah,
well done.
I will.
Wow. Next two, please. Let's go. Right, first name is?
Amanda.
What's the dish?
This is eggplant rollantini with creamy polenta.
This is seasoned perfectly.
Thank you, chef.
There's talent there.
Definitely. Thank you, chef.
Good job.
Wait, that's fucking high praise coming from him. I'm on cloud nine right now.
Okay. So first name is?
Brandon.
Brandon, what is it?
It's a recipe I hope that you recognize. This is salmon with a basil cream sauce. This came from Harvey's restaurant where you were a cook.
That's right.
That's why I wanted to make it for you.
I did a lot of research, and I really wanted to show Chef Ramsay that I'm the type of guy that will go the extra distance.
I mean, salmon's cooked perfectly. Sauce is seasoned nice. Congratulations to both of you. You both got the point.
Yeah.
Well done. Next two, please. Ladies first. First name is?
Jennifer.
Jennifer, from where?
Boston, Massachusetts.
What's the dish?
It's called Jenny's Pork. It's my special marinade on my pork. Please, Chef Ramsay, please do not spit out my food.
It's not bad. The pork's moist and tasty.
Thank you.
Someone up above answered me. It didn't suck.
Pork's actually quite nice. Jonathan, from where?
Memphis, Tennessee.
What the fuck is that on a plate?
Call this the punch drunk chicken. I got the southern flavor, you know, I put a lot of flavor in the food, raw but real. So if Chef Ramsay complains about it, well, he's full of shit, man.
Hold on, it gets worse. The pineapple looks like canned?
Yes.
You open a can of pineapple and you stick it on top of a chicken.
Limited time today.
Limited time? 45 minutes? Limited time? You're so full of shit, even your eyes are brown. While you come in here and serve me a canned fucking pineapple, you can fuck off now. Serious? I'll pay for the ticket. You tell me.
No, sir.
It's an absolute freaking mess. But the surprising fact was you opened it out of a can. That's what pissed me off more than anything. I'm not even gonna taste it. Ladies, congratulations. Let's go. Next two, please.
Come on, Paul. Let's go, buddy.
Right, first name, and what in the hell is that on there?
My name is Krupa. This is a traditional Gujarati dish of stuffed naan.
First off, it doesn't exactly look appetizing, does it?
No.
No, it's like you've got four bits of arse wipe on a plate, splat.
You're right.
Spices are raw, bland. My dear Krupa, yeah, that is crapper.
He thought of me as a joke. I'm better than this. I'm so much more better than this.
Right, first name is?
Paul.
Paul, what's the dish?
It's an eggplant involtini with crab and mascarpone and ricotta.
It's actually quite nice.
Thank you, chef.
You're a natural cook. Congratulations to the gents. Good job.
Thank you, chef.
Slam dunk. Next two, let's go, please. First name?
Jamie.
What'd you do?
I'm a sous chef.
You're already a sous chef?
Yes. I'm still a young chef, but I know how good I am.
Tell me about the dish.
It's lamb lollipops with red onion confiture.
Mm-hmm. You've overcooked the most important thing, the lamb. If you're gonna have the balls to call yourself a sous chef, learn to cook lamb properly first.
Yes, chef.
Okay,
Stephen.
What is that?
I have sea diver scallops over wild mushroom risotto. I've been cooking 30 years. Nobody else has a chance in this thing.
Honestly, it's like toenails from a fucking dinosaur. Look at them.
It's got good flavor.
It's got good flavor. You can't be that deluded. The point goes to none of you. Stop fucking around.
Sorry, chef.
Okay, let's go.
After two disappointing dishes, line cook Elise...
The scallops are cooked perfectly.
Thank you, chef.
...takes on New Jersey executive chef Chino.
The miso is so strong, and it doesn't really sit well. Well done, Elise.
And Elise ties it for the red team.
Next two, please. Thank you.
Now line cook Monterey...
The sea bass you've nailed.
Thank you, sir.
...squares off against Kentucky sous chef Natalie.
The lamb is perfect.
Thank you, chef.
Congratulations. You both got the point. Okay, let's go. Both, so let's go.
With the score tied at four, line cook Elizabeth...
It's got that impact.
...makes an impression on Chef Ramsay.
It works. The dish works.
While line cook Tommy...
The tattoo on the forehead. Could you just lift it up so I can have a quick look, if you don't mind?
Says rock and roll.
...makes an impression of his own.
So I've got to take you serious.
I'd appreciate it if you did.
There's finesse in there. It tastes nice.
Thank you.
Points going to both of you. Well done.
All right.
Well done. Let's go.
Come on, Jason. Come on,
last chance.
Now, with the score tied, it all comes down to the last two dishes.
What's the dish?
This is pan-roasted pistachio scallops with pureed parsnip.
The actual scallops, they taste nice, but you burn the top of them.
Yes, my scallops were a little bit burnt, but he said they tasted good. I was kind of in a panic.
What is it?
It's a pork taco.
Why would you choose to do a taco on a day like today?
Because it's delicious. Me being the last person up and knowing that I am just bringing up tacos, so I was so nervous. I personally believe it's very delicious, and I hope that you'll say.
Oh, fuck me.
It's gonna be great.
Well, let's do it properly, shall we? Point goes to.
Come on.
Gentlemen, good job.
Thank you, chef.
Oh boy, Jason.
Looks a mess, yet it tastes delicious. Good job.
This is huge. I pulled off a win with some tacos. Such an awesome feeling.
Well done. Okay, gents, you'll be treated to a unique feast in one of the hottest restaurants in downtown LA. Wining and dining with last season's winner of Hell's Kitchen, Nona. How's that sound?
Awesome.
Excellent, chef.
Thanks, chef.
Good. Okay, ladies, you've got one miserable, horrible evening. You'll be preparing Hell's Kitchen for the opening, cleaning both kitchens. Got it?
Yes, chef.
Yes, chef.
Good. Let's go.
After claiming their first victory, the men head to LA Market at LA Live.
This is awesome!
To meet with last season's winner.
Nona! It felt really good to see Nona. It was inspirational.
I got ripped apart tonight.
Yeah, that's okay, so did I. Every day when you go in there and you fight and you put your best foot forward every day, you have to remember that this is for your life. It's not just fun and games.
Sitting and talking to Nona kind of gave me an extra boost. I listened to everything she said and I took it to heart, and I'm just going to use that to my advantage.
Let's have a toast to the women that's scrubbing our mess.
Blue.
What is that?
The kitchen looks like a fucking tornado went through it. There's no room for anything because there are so many dishes.
I put points on the board and I'm still fucking mopping. I'm a little upset that I'm here cleaning because I earned my point. That's right, I won. Krupa and Carrie sunk our team. If it wasn't for those two, we would be like out eating dinner right now.
It's the end of the first day in Hell's Kitchen. And with the grand reopening of the restaurant awaiting them,
here we go.
The aspiring chefs are anxious to start their prep.
This is our first service. The nerves are building, man. The tension is building. But all in all, I think we're just going to dominate the red team.
Morning, chef.
How are we all doing today?
Great, chef.
We provided you with your own J.A. Hinkle knife sets. Each one of you have a set.
Oh, my God. Those Hinkle knives are the bomb.
These knives are sharp.
Let's go, ladies. Let's get it together. Crank it up and regroup.
We lost because of my horrible dish. I'm hoping I will be able to shine today because if I fail twice, I'm going to shoot myself.
Sorry.
While most of the chefs are feeling upbeat, one chef seems to have lost his rhythm.
Pepper? Relax,
I'm getting like dizzy and shit.
Relax, bro. Stop, take a breath, bro. You know?
That's all I'm doing is breathing. I don't feel good at all.
Jason looked like shit. So I decided to go looking for him. I helped him over to the medic.
What's going on, man?
He's burning up. He needs to cool down. You can tell he's overheated. Dude's sweating a lot. Relax, come sit down.
I'm fine.
He needs to take it down a notch.
I just want to fucking go cook. I feel really weak.
How long has this been going on for?
I've been breathing like this like for the past hour.
An hour? Okay.
All right.
You don't really sound all right.
Why are my arms so, like, weak?
Because you're breathing all crazy.
I'm like, what the hell, is he having a heart attack or something? That wasn't looking too good for him.
Chino, you're on desserts right now, bro, all right? 100% I care about Jason's well-being, but regardless, we can't sit there and harp on it because we still have a service to put out. This is what a kitchen's about, man. We got to pull through, guys.
I gotcha.
I'm fine.
There you go. Why don't we take some of the stuff off you because it's all wet.
I'm fine. Hey, I'm sorry, I don't mean to be like feisty, but I'm just really pissed off.
Minutes before service, Jason is rushed to the hospital, and Chef Ramsay lets the chefs in on his status.
Right, listen carefully, please. Not good news. Unfortunately, Jason's been taken to the hospital. He'll be on a few days of bed rest. He will not be returning back to Hell's Kitchen.
Damn, like, we didn't even really get out of the gates, and then, like, we're down a man. Like, how the hell that happened?
I trust the rest of you are ready to go, yes?
Yes! Yes. Yeah.
And I'm looking for a smooth service. What's it gonna be?
Smooth, chef!
Let's go.
Yes, chef!
Jason's gone.
Yeah, it sucks because he's a good guy, but I have no doubt in my mind that 8 of us guys are better than 9 of those girls.
James.
Yes, chef.
Open Hell's Kitchen.
Yes, chef.
Tonight, Hell's Kitchen is once again the place to be in Los Angeles. The restaurant has been redesigned with a stunning balcony above the kitchen that gives those diners a unique view of the action in the kitchen.
Okay, all right. First order, chef.
Let's go. Okay, blue team, here we are. First thing of the blue team. One risotto, one scallops, one squab, one spaghetti.
Yes, chef. Yes, chef. I'm sorry, chef, can you repeat that?
Can I repeat that?
I'm sorry,
yeah,
chef.
Let me repeat it. Fuck yourself.
Yes, sir.
Can I repeat that? Is he fucking stupid? Okay, red team, come here, let's go. First ticket. Good luck.
Yes,
two
chef.
Covers away, table 41, scallops, one risotto. Entree, one New York. Hey, madam.
Sorry.
I'm not going to shout over you. I've got
sorry.
10 seconds, a window to call these out. Come here, you. Big mouth, come here. Call out the fucking ticket. Come here. Call out the ticket.
Y'all ready? We need one scallop, two risotto for appetizers.
While Elise delivers the order in the red kitchen.
Thank you.
Over in the blue kitchen, one chef has made a delivery of his own.
Monterey, why are you giving me garnish?
He's got fired a little bit too early, chef.
So what does garnish go with?
Garnish goes with the entree, chef.
Right, so are the entrees ready?
No, chef.
So why are you even sending them on the own? We haven't even sent the first fucking table appetizers. Now I've got the fucking garnish.
My apologies, chef, never again.
Fuck off, Monterey.
While Monterey struggles with his timing.
Come on, guys, get a grip, talk to each other.
Back in the red kitchen, Carrie is ready with her first appetizer.
We got it? We good?
Yep, let's go.
Scallops going to the pass.
So now we got scallops and no risotto. Where's the risotto?
In my hand, chef.
My scallops are up in the pass. It was extremely frustrating because I'm doing my part. I was just like, Elise, come on. Make some fucking risotto.
Walking with a risotto.
Stop. No chance. It doesn't even look like a fucking risotto. It's like a rice pudding. Look at it. You start showing me you don't care about my fucking customers,
care.
I'm gonna start showing you that I don't care about you.
Yes, chef.
You understand? Can no one make a fucking risotto?
I'm on it, chef. Krupa's jumping on it, chef.
I got it. Krupa? You're gonna have Krupa replace me? I'll kick Krupa's ass with a blindfold and a broken arm.
While Krupa fires up a new risotto,
fire.
Over in the blue kitchen, Steven is eager to deliver his food to Chef Ramsay.
Can I come up with it? How's this gal? Let's go up with it right now. Can I go?
Go up with it.
Don't go up with it, man.
Can I go? I'm ready.
No,
Wellington.
No.
Lots of spaghetti up, guys.
Oh, fuck me. So the lobster's ready for the second table, thanks to Steven. Well, I just want the first.
I'm working on the first.
So guy. Why are you giving me the second?
I'll go one at a time.
The thought of you doing two things at once, forget it.
Okay.
Just focus on the first ticket, Steven.
Yes, chef.
Talk, all right, bro. All right.
Steven was very easily flustered, and I told him it wasn't a time to put it up.
Risotto, scallop, we can go.
We don't have the time to sit here and do shit twice.
Going to the window. Coming on the side, chef.
Adiós.
Table 23, please. Let's go.
Thanks to Will, the Blue Diners are finally receiving their first appetizers.
Thank you.
Meanwhile, back in the red kitchen, Krupa.
Walking with your risotto.
Has delivered her risotto for Chef Ramsay's approval.
Who made that risotto?
I did, chef.
Yeah, delicious.
Thank you. Good job, Krupa. Oh, Krupa's back! Woo! Go team!
Hey.
Sorry.
Oh, make 10 more like that, finish service, and maybe.
Yes, chef.
But don't stop.
paying your knickers now.
Yes, chef.
It's an hour into dinner service, and with Krupa's help, food is finally making its way out to the red diners.
Very good. There we are.
The total's really good.
Meanwhile, the blue kitchen has moved on to entrees.
Blue team, it's the first table. Come on.
And Chino is bringing his fish to the pass.
What's he done to this? Blue team.
Yes, chef.
No garnish anywhere. Still fragmented. And look, it's burnt.
I burned a miso cod. You know, I should know this shit too, because I'm Asian.
Oh, guys.
Chino really fucked your cod up, man. Basted that motherfucker with roof tar or something.
Chino!
Yes, chef?
Come here, you. Get out of my sight.
Sit down.
Scott, get him peeling onions, garlic, but away from the stove.
There you go. At least you won't be able to burn any of that.
Ugh. Horrible.
Absolute fucking useless.
While a benched Chino watches from the sidelines,
I want all the entrees.
Yes, chef.
Krupa is ready to lead her team once again with their first entrees.
Let's get these entrees out together. As girls, we've made a pact. We are not losing tonight. Wellington's ready. I'm walking with it right now. So it's a little bit more pressure for me not to fuck up.
Who cooked the Wellington? Perfect.
Yes, chef, thank you.
Thank God.
It was perfect.
Let's go, then. Let's just kick the boy's ass.
Damn,
please.
Right.
Service, go with the Wellington, please. An entree leaving the kitchen. Finally, let's go.
Krupa's leadership has helped the red team get entrees out to their hungry diners.
It's worth the wait.
Meanwhile, in the blue kitchen,
Scouts, are ready to go?
Almost.
Steven has taken Chino's place on the fish station.
Fish was sinking like an anchor. I said, you know, let me go help them out. I know I could cook good.
Scallops, where are they?
Yes.
Let's go, you. Put the plate down and work with two hands.
Sorry, chef.
Hurry up.
Scouts are in the window.
Hey, come here. Just touch.
They're springy, chef.
They're what?
Springy. When you spring back, usually they're ready.
So they're ready, are they?
I feel that they're ready.
That fucking rubbery.
Sorry, chef. Everything Stephen was touching was turning to shit tonight. You know how they say you can't teach an old dog new tricks?
Sit down and eat them. Enjoy your springy scallops. Let me know how you feel halfway through. Bon appetit.
Oh, I think they're perfect.
Come on, fellas, come on.
Chef Ramsay has already benched two members of the blue team.
I need two scallops!
He is now looking for Tommy to rescue the fish station.
How's that?
Hey, rock and roll. Bozo, come here.
Shit.
I go from springy to boil bits of shit.
Yeah, this sucks. Took a hell of a dive.
Take a seat and fucking eat them. Service, please. A little glass of wine, Sauvignon Blanc, goes beautifully well with the raw ceviche skillet.
Hell's Kitchen weeds out the weak. This competition is mine, and it's only a matter of time.
One, two, three of you, all on the frickin' fish station.
I jumped over to help out,
Yeah, I wish you jumped in the oven. That would make my life a lot easier.
Nearly 2 hours into dinner service, the blue team has completely stalled on the fish station. But over in the red kitchen,
scallops are going up to the pass.
Carrie is ready to impress Chef Ramsay with her scallops.
Carrie, scallops overcooked. Let's go. I want more color. The pan's got to be hot.
Yes, chef. Oh, we're not about to go down on some scallops.
Come on, please.
Scallops are coming, chef.
Let's go.
This early in the game, you know, get your shit together, keep it moving.
Look, they're boiled. Rubber and boiled.
This is very, very frustrating, because I just wanted to make Chef Ramsay proud.
Start again.
Yes, chef.
As the red team comes to a screeching halt.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
No food is leaving either kitchen.
I'm pretending it's my beef Wellington.
And the diners, not surprisingly, are getting restless.
We don't need any more wine, we need food.
Cod, duck, lamb, Wellington, how long?
5 minutes, chef.
Monterey, can you talk to me?
5 minutes, chef, heard.
I want the garnish 30 seconds before the protein hit the window. Got it?
Yes, chef.
Let's just put up one fucking table.
Serious? I can't get a Pinot Noir, are they a little red?
There's your teamwork there. Really concerned. The three frickin' stooges.
Got the Wellington coming up.
Jonathan! Look at it!
Sure, Chef, I apologize.
It's cooked perfectly.
Thank you, Chef.
First one of the fucking night, let's
Thanks,
go.
Chef. I have never in my fucking life cooked a beef Wellington, but I've rocked it today, and I'm gonna keep on rocking it, man.
I got my Wellington ready. Monterey, Brandon, I've got a Wellington cooked perfectly, but where's the fucking garnish?
Muffle up, fellas, muffle up.
How long on garnish?
2 minutes.
The protein's cooked perfectly. Right now, it's stone cold.
Goddamn.
Monterey, I got this. Yeah, you got just a big old bag of what the fuck.
Here you fucking go. Take it. He's not even 2 minutes away. He's fucking miles away.
Get another Wellington in now.
We cannot lose this dinner service. Like, my ass is, like, seriously on the line.
While the blue team tries to recover from Monterey's mistimed garnish.
Oh, wait now, one sea bass, one chicken, one Wellington.
Yes, chef.
Back in the red kitchen, Carrie is looking to redeem herself on the fish station.
I'll cook the fish. I'll cook it.
But Elise has other plans.
I got it, babe. No, I got it. It's my station. Thank you.
Clearly, Carrie is a weaker cook than I am, so I felt like I wanted to take charge to impress Chef Ramsay.
Why is she cooking fish?
I don't know what she's doing. She just came over here and grabbed it, Chef. I mean, are you fucking kidding me? That bitch is crazy.
What in the fuck is she doing?
I didn't let her cook it. She came over and grabbed it, Chef.
Well, I was going to cook it for you because we're all a team, right?
She's trying to prove a point.
Elise!
Yes, Chef?
I got a six top dying for the appetizers, and you're cooking fish.
I put the spaghetti up.
You, fuck off. Sit on the chef table.
While Elise spends time in the penalty box, back on the blue side...
Jonathan, where are we? Wellington coming up.
Jonathan has delivered another perfectly cooked Wellington.
Good.
All it needs now is the garnish from Brendan.
Filet's already up, bro. Watch the potatoes, they're about to burn.
Got him.
Flip them, pull them up.
We're waiting on the sides.
Got him.
Brendan, look at me. The potatoes in front of you, they're burnt. You're standing over them.
Yes, Chef.
Brendan want to sit there and puff out his fucking chest. I know how to fucking do this. I'm the fucking man. Bullshit, bro. You suck.
Come on, guys.
That's twice in a row. Cooked to perfection, and we can't even send a table together because nobody's together. Smooth service, my ass.
I've never in my whole career ever been stopped by fucking side items. Never.
The Wellingtons were coming out amazing, and I was getting held up by fucking potatoes. Come on. Do you have any idea how fucking frustrating that is?
Paul thinks he's a badass on the grill. Don't you fucking talk to me, dumpling.
Oh, we're fucked.
With no food coming out of either kitchen, James has spotted a disturbing trend in the dining room.
Chef?
James.
Tables are walking out.
Blue team, they're walking out. You muppets, get off your fat ass. Let me show you something. Not one entree has left this fucking kitchen. Not one.
Yes, Chef.
And look at the pans back there. Any bright ideas?
You want me to jump in? I'll clean them.
I'm talking about the customers, not the freaking pans.
Yes, Chef.
Any ideas?
No.
Hey, what are we going to do now? They are walking out. Fuck off.
At that point, it was a train wreck on ice. There was nothing we could do about it.
Stop. You're out of your misery.
Let's do this, ladies. Come on, let's not disappoint the customers.
Kerry, they've gone. Shut it down. This, for me, has been the most disappointing opening ever. Kerry, it wasn't the scallops I was concerned about. It's about that nothing else was timed with it.
Well, the risotto kept coming back. What was I supposed to do about that?
Don't try to throw me under the bus
about
the risotto
because
your scallops came back more than once. Your scallops came back more than twice, and I offered to help you on the fish station because you can't cook fish.
Paul, Jonathan, you were sort of standing there with your pants down, getting absolutely fucked every second. How'd you feel?
Fucking irate. I sent up the same shit 4 fucking times and I waited for potatoes and fucking carrots.
Brendan, are you not bothered or is it just...
I am bothered, Chef, but we'll try not to let him down next time, Chef.
Wow.
And I'm really happy for Paul that he actually learned how to cook proteins.
You want to pull him out right now, man? I mean, that what you want?
Hey,
we can lay him out on the table if you want
it.
To. I mean,
Sounds
honestly.
Good, buddy.
I mean, I'm just calling it as I see it. I'm just saying.
The losing team tonight with 0 entrees leaving the kitchen is the blue team. Get back upstairs to the dorm, work as a team, and come to a consensus on which two are up for elimination.
Brandon don't know his ass from his elbow. Like, let me tell you something. In baseball, this was a fucking swing and a miss, strike three, then you hit yourself in the nuts with the bat.
Anybody want to speak?
Paulie, dude, it's all you, man.
First of all, you ever pull that fucking shit on me again, I will fucking slap you across the goddamn
head. Shut up, dumpling. I'll say whatever the fuck I want, all right? Whatever the fuck I want, meatball, all right?
All right.
Don't ever act like a tough guy again to me.
Tough guy?
Yeah.
You had to fucking...
You had to fucking... You look like a little fucking breadcrumb dumpling ass. Really, this guy is a meatball. He got real lucky tonight. You're irate.
I am irate.
I'll say this. Obviously, Paul and Jonathan, those two sat there, they banged, bro.
I think we should take it to a vote.
I'm gonna call it out, man. Sorry, bro. No offense. I'm gonna call it Steven as number one.
No, listen. I'm a team quiet.
We all get that. We're all
so being. You didn't even get entrees out. Chino was burning fish left and right. At least I fed some people apps. Did they feed any entrees? No, big zero.
Sorry, I'm gonna go Brandon and Chino. Just because nothing on that side got up.
This fucking sucks, dude.
It's what we signed up for, guys.
Mm-hmm.
Somebody's gonna go home, bro. Men, have you reached a consensus?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yeah.
Jonathan, who was the first nomination?
The blue team's first nomination was Steve.
Why?
Just the different methods he used and failed.
The blue team's second nominee?
Well, Bonnaray actually was second.
Why, please?
I've never had sides stop an entree from going out, and it was really fucked up, you know. It pissed me off a good bit.
Yeah, worthy nominees. But truthfully, I think there are three individuals deserving to step forward this evening. Stephen Monterey and Chino. Three of you, step forward, please. Let's go. Monterey.
Yes, Chef.
Why do you think you should stay in Hell's Kitchen?
I think I should stay in Hell's Kitchen, Chef, because I know I can do better than Stephen.
Stephen.
Yes, Chef.
Why Steven?
He tried to step up to the plate and he really didn't do what he said he was going to do.
Neither did you.
Yeah, Chef, I know. I mean, at the end of the day, I was still in there fighting. You know, I tried to give him my all. No matter how bad I started off, I kept fighting.
Chino, it just wasn't the garnish that stopped the entrees coming out.
Yes, Chef.
You had a pivotal position on the fish.
It's certainly unacceptable. I thought I could do it until the miso cod and I definitely overextended myself, and I should have said something, but I didn't.
You spent more time prepping garlic than you actually did physically cooking. I'm looking for an executive chef. I'm not looking for a prep cook. So, Stephen, you saw what went on?
Yes, Chef.
Who do you think, out of all three of you, should be leaving?
Well, I already chose Monterey. Chino and I, we did get a few appetizers out.
Right now, I'm having a difficult time. Honestly, all three of you sucked. My decision is... Chino and Monterey. That's right. Both of you back in line. Steven. Jack it off. Your time is done. Short and sweet. Thank you. Sorry, but I can't go through that again.
It's embarrassing being the first one kicked off. I think that Chef Ramsay made a mistake, but it is what it is. It's done. You know, nice guys always finish last. That's probably me.
Hell's Kitchen is a series of tests And so far, we have achieved a failing grade. Get a grip. Fast. Got it?
Yes, sir. Sure.
Fuck off.
Chef Ramsay gave me another chance, so I gotta bring my A++++ game. I'ma keep fighting. I ain't hear no bell. I gotta bring it.
And I'm so glad that I know that I am capable and that I pulled it off today.
From this point on, I'm just gonna get better and better and better and better.
Now it's time for me and Paul to go to the mattresses. It's somebody I'm gonna have to keep my eye on, and it's somebody that I'm gonna have to eliminate sooner rather than later.
Not me. I realized early on that Stephen had as much chance of being the head chef at BLT Steak as I do of winning a gold medal in figure skating.
Next time on Hell's Kitchen.
Let's go!
A rude awakening.
What the fuck?
Is followed by a feud on the red team.
Stop it already?
Oh, God, I just moved.
Then.
Let's move!
At dinner service.
What the fuck is going on?
One chef does something so shocking.
Come on! Are you lying to me? Why?
It threatens to destroy the blue team.
I'm tired of getting my ass kicked!
For good.
I did not come out here to be made a fool of.
Next time.
What are we gonna do now?
On a thrilling.
I ain't signed up for this, bro.
Unbelievable.
Embarrassing.
And explosive. Hell's Kitchen.